and gentlemen, boys and girls, and Pokemon fans of the world, it's your boy Mega Crasher, coming at you pumped up, coming at you hardcore, and I come at you guys back again once again with a brand new video, baby, and this is our follow-up to our 5K Q&A special. This is the video where I react to and I answer your guys' questions, and I just gotta say, I cannot wait to see what you guys ask me. So, with all that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's get into this video. I'm so excited, baby. Woo! Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so the first person to ask the questions happens to be Ash Greninja, and we got two questions, baby. So here we go. And the first question is, what if you were a Pokemon trainer? Man, oh man alive. If I was a Pokemon trainer, I'd probably be the most insane and intense Pokemon trainer that there ever was. I mean, like, the thing of it is, just take a look at me. Take a look at these eyes, man. Take a look. Yeah, you can see the fire that burns in these eyes. The wildness that burns in my soul. I think you guys can put two and two together. I would be the most insane Pokemon trainer that there is. I mean, I'm already the most insane Pokemon YouTuber that there is, without question. So, if I was a Pokemon trainer, that would be one of the most hypest things that you could ever be. And I just gotta say that if Pokemon were to exist in real life, I would go out of my way to get me a Metagross and a Golisopod, because those two Pokemon are absolutely awesome! Woo! But, ladies and gentlemen, let's see the second question that this cool cat asked. How would you react if Ash Greninja came back to Alola? Oh, shit! Dude, if Ash Greninja came back to the Alola region, that would be absolutely hyped. I mean, Ash Greninja was like one of the main reasons to watch the Pokemon X, Y, and Z anime. It still sucks that he lost in the finals against Alon, because Alon winning the Pokemon League served no purpose for the overall anime. Like, his character, it had pretty much next to no development. I'm not exactly hating on Alon. I love Alon and his Mega Charizard X and all that stuff. But the writing was on the wall when it came to Ash Greninja and Ash being the main stars of the series. So it made absolutely no sense. It made absolutely no sense. That's why I stopped watching and reacting to that anime, because it was just absolute. The wind was taken out of my sails, because Ash Greninja was absolutely awesome, and Ash Greninja would have been like just. It would have been perfect if Ash Greninja won the Pokemon League for Ash. But if he was to make a comeback to the Alola region, man, oh man, I would lose my shit, okay? Like, this would be a huge return. So, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and let's move on to the next person who asked the questions. So coming up next, we have the Sylveon Station asks me, what is your favorite Pokemon game? Oh, shit. Dude, that's gotta be a very difficult question. I don't think I have, like, a personal favorite, because I love all of the Pokemon games. They all had some sort of impact on me in a different way, shape, or form, you know? Like, it's so weird. But the thing is, ladies and gentlemen, is that I love all the Pokemon games, okay? I love all the Pokemon games. I can't decide. I'm sorry, the Sylveon Station, I can't answer your question accurately. But the thing is that, like, I loved all the Pokemon games, okay? Like, I grew up with Gen 1, so by default, I love Gen 1. Gen 2 was, like, felt like the continuation of Gen 1, which was absolutely perfect. Then we get to Gen 3. Gen 3 introduced Metagross, which was, like one of my favorite Pokemon of all time, okay? And then came Gen 4. Gen 4 had, like, a mystical and a very awesome feel to it. And then we get to Gen 5. Gen 5, although, like, the thing is that, like, there's some people that would complain about the designs of the Pokemon in Gen 5. They felt like that there was way too many Pokemon introduced in Gen 5, but the story was awesome, and it all came together in Black 2 and White 2, okay? And then we get to Gen 6. Too many good memories for that, man! And then we get to Gen 7. And Gen 7 was, like, fucking amazing. Like, dude, it was absolutely amazing, not to mention it introduced Golisopod, which became my favorite 7th Gen Pokemon! And then we get to the remakes, okay? We get to Fire Red and Leaf Green. Absolutely amazing! Like, just the additional amount of content there was in that Gen 1 remake. Okay? And then we get to the Gen 2 remakes, that being Heart Gold and Soul Silver. Like, Fuck! Those games were incredible. Like, you were able to catch legendary Pokemon from Gen 1 and Gen 2, okay? Not to mention, there was crazy-ass events that allowed for you to interact with Pokemon, legendary Pokemon, I should say, from different generations. And then we get to the Gen 3 remix. The Gen 3 remix, where it features Mega Metagross getting an Mega Evolution! And that was absolutely amazing. Not to mention, like, the Primal Kyogre, Primal Groudon, Mega Rayquaza? Are you kidding me? Like, giving those Pokemon access to powerful forms? That's just nuts! And I just gotta say, like, those remakes were absolutely amazing. So here's the thing. What is your favorite Pokemon game? I can't decide because they're all my favorites, man. Woo! But with that being said, I hope you appreciate my intense response. But with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on to the next cool cat who has asked the questions. So coming up next, we got William Dow. And this individual has, holy shit, we got 6 questions. All right, let's see if we can rattle these ones off. So, number 1, why are you happy and positive a lot? Well, here's the thing, man, is that if y'all took a look at yourself in the mirror and you would see the answer right there, you guys are the reasons why I'm always so happy and positive a lot. So here's the thing, man, is that, like, with the fact that you guys are so awesome and so legendary, you can bet your ass that even if I was down and depressed, I wouldn't be down and depressed for so long because I've got all of you amazing people to turn to and all of you amazing people to gift me with the ability to be even more positive and happy, man. But with that, let's see what we got going on with other questions. What is your favorite color? Blue, baby. Blue's always been my favorite color, and orange being a very slight second. And then the third question is, do you like the Pokemon game, Pokemon Colosseum, or Pokemon XD, Gales of Darkness, or both? I can't accurately answer that question because I've never played those games before. Ah! I really want to try those games out, though. You know what I'm saying, man? And number 4, do you prefer Mega Evolutions or Z-Moves or both? I prefer both because they're so fucking awesome, man. The animations, the moves, the forms, fucking everything is so awesome. Woo! Well, let's keep going. What do you like about the movie Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2? Well, I can't answer that question because I haven't yet seen it, so please don't eat on me for not answering the question. And then the 6th question is, how would you react if Ash, Greninja, and Lycanroc just form talk to each other? And would you be happy about that? Hell yeah, I'd be happy about that because, like, Ash, Greninja, making a fucking return. See, that was the main reason to watch Pokemon XYZ anime was because of Ash, Greninja. And the thing is that Dusk Lycanroc is one of the most pivotal reasons to watch the Sun and Moon anime. So if they were to both make a fucking return and fucking talk to each other, man, and work together to be the fucking best duo that there fucking ever was, that would be absolutely amazing, man. Oh, shit. I don't know what I would do with myself. I don't know how I would react. But with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we have to keep moving on, man, because I am just getting started. I'm just getting warmed up. Thank you, William Dell, and everyone who has asked me questions so far. But we got so much more to talk about. So let's go, baby. So coming up next, we have Chuji Studio Plus. Plans on your 10K plus celebration. Whoa, dude. I didn't know we had 10K already. See, here's the thing, man, is that 10K is going to be a long road ahead of us, okay? Ain't no mistaking in that, but you can rest assured that when we do hit 10K, there is going to be a huge kind of celebration, man, because here's the thing, is that we aren't just celebrating a community milestone. We're celebrating 10,000 plus people that are subscribed to this community. That is incredible. So I would have to do something very fucking huge for that, man. You know what I mean? But, like, as for the actual plans itself, you would have to stay tuned for that shit, man, because here's the thing, is that not even I have anything planned out for 10K yet. But the thing is, man, is I'm a fast thinker. I'm a critical thinker. I'm a very intense thinker. So when we get to that road, man, when we get to that goal, oh, you can bet your ass, there's going to be something amazing and monumental to celebrate that and more. But with all that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's now move on to the next cool cat that has asked the questions. So up next, we have Seth Mars, baby. This individual asks, did you or do you wrestle any martial arts with all that energy? You really should have not. See, here's the thing, man, is that I didn't get a chance to wrestle, but I know I can do it because I'm a grappler, and you guys know, you can see the intensity in my eyes. I would be a dangerous force in that ring. And have I ever done any martial arts? I've done Taekwondo, but see, the thing is, man, is that sport is about kicking. I got the short-ass T-Rex dinosaur legs, and I'm not very flexible. I'm more about the wrestling, okay? I'm not a kicker, I'm not a puncher, even though I love to punch things that resemble a screen, like my webcam, although I'm not gonna really do it right now, because here's the thing, I see no reason to do that, but the thing is, man, is that if I was to get involved into any MMA, it would be wrestling, okay? It would be just full-on contact wrestling, because that is what I love to do the most. And will you battle with subscribers on Showdown? Seems like a good video theme, man. See, here's the thing, man, is that if we were able to become, like, if I was able to organize something that involved a lot of people to coordinate with me, or even better, if I had the ability to live stream, man, you can bet your ass I would be hosting fucking live stream videos when it comes to battling with my amazing people that are subscribed to our community, man, because the thing is that I can't even talk. What makes battles even more fun is battling with the people that you love and care about by battling with the people that love your content. And the thing is that it would be absolutely amazing because, see, it ain't about winning and losing, because, see, the true victory for me is being able to have a chance to battle and communicate even more with you guys. So, yes, once I have a chance to be able to get access to better Wi-Fi, once I have a chance to be able to get access to, like, stronger equipment, like, in other words, like, I can't just have a laptop, okay? I need to have, like, a computer or something, and with really strong internet, so I'd be able to just live stream more effectively, so that way I could host live streams where it involves this crazy nut house battling all of you amazing cool cats. So, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's now move on to the next cool cat who asks some questions. So coming up next, we have nice Pokemon Strong number one. Where do you live? I live in Nova Scotia, Canada, brother. More specifically, Lower Sackville, Nova Scotia, Canada. And what is your favorite region? Ah, come on, man. It's just like asking me what are my favorite Pokemon games. I love all the regions, man. I love the Alola region. I love the Kalos region. I love the Unova region. I love the Sinnoh region. I love the Hoenn region. I love the Johto region. I love the Kanto region. I love the Nidoqua region. Well, they didn't even come up with a Nidoqua goddamn region yet. I really hope they do. And Game Freak, if by chance you happen to be watching this video, man, and you're watching up to this point, please make a Nidoqua region where it features me being the main antagonist, the main champion, the main fucking everything, man. Mega Crasher for the Nidoqua region, man. Hashtag that shit. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and let's move on to the next cool cat with the questions. So we got my man, it's Bray. Let's see what you asked me, buddy. So what month or year can you predict hitting 10K? Meaning what month or year do you think you'll hit 10K? I would honestly love it if we hit 10K by 2018 on my 28th birthday, meaning September 25th. If we were to hit 10K on my birthday, man, holy shit, that would be absolutely amazing if we were to do that. But, like, the thing is, here's the thing. I always say never, but it is a long stretch to be able to gain another 5K amazing people subscribed at around this time next year. But you never know, man. I could make a video that could absolutely blow up, be on the trending page, and, you know, have a whole bunch of new cool cats coming up to our community. You just never know, right? But see, that's the thing, though, man, is that for that to happen, I gotta work even harder than I already do, which is 100%, but I gotta go even past 100%, even though that might be mathematically incorrect. The thing is that we ain't talking about mathematicals, we're talking about this. We're talking about us, okay? And with us, anything is possible, even if it may seem impossible. So, with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on, baby. So, Master Quest has asked a question as, will you do LPs? In other words, let's plays. See, here's the thing, man, is that I would love to do LPs, man. But the thing is that I don't have a Nintendo 3DS with a capture card. It's like, no! That would be one of the most ultimate things to do on this channel, would be let's plays with Mega Crasher, because you know how crazy things would get, especially reactionary-wise, if something crazy stupid was to happen, crazy monumental. But the thing is, never say never, you never know down the road, man, because there's also a thing called emulators, too. And if I'm able to play on an emulator without that shit crashing in my face, then I just might be able to do an LP of an old Pokemon game, like maybe Pokemon Gen 1, Pokemon Gen 2, Pokemon Gen 3, or something like that. And it would be an absolutely amazing community series. You know why? Because it would be the first time ever that you see your boy Mega Crasher be able to do an LP. So never say never. Will you do LPs? Never say never. Maybe so, maybe not. You know what I mean? But with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. So, Jack the Battler asks, yee! Anyways, what is your favorite competitive format? Oh, shit, dude. I don't think I have a solid top contender tier Pokemon format, but I will say this, Gen 7 OU and Gen 7 Random Battles. I love those tiers, not to mention Gen 7 Anything Goes. Like, Gen 6 Anything Goes was absolutely amazing, but Gen 7 Anything Goes is even better, man. And the thing is that Gen 7 OU, well, OU in general has always been my bread and butter. It's always been my main competitive tier, but we then get to the Gen 7 Random Battles. We get to the Random Battle format itself. And you see how good I am at that tier. You see what kind of intensity, what kind of passion that that shit brings out of me, man. It is absolutely amazing. I love Random Battles. But with that being said, my top three picks would be Anything Goes, OU, and Random Battle. You know what I'm saying, baby? But with all that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on to the next cool cat. So, coming up next, oh, we got my bro, Jason Lowe, and that whole line just rhymed, but I'm no rapper, man. So, number one, does pineapple go on a pizza? Well, see, here's the thing. I think it does. It adds that extra bit of sweetness to it, man. Not to mention, pineapples are not only very juicy, but they're very tasty also, man. So, I mean, even the craziest things could work on the most unlikeliest of food items. You know what I mean? Number two, do you have the patience for puzzles? I know you need choke the puzzle given the choice, but nuh-uh, not for this question. Believe me, there's always times and always instances where knee chokes are acceptable and knee chokes are called for, man. So, do I have the patience for puzzles? Yes, but if I can't solve the puzzle, well, actually, here's the thing. Everything is always solved with a simple little knee choke. So, if I can't solve it with my brain, I solve it with my knees, baby. And the third question is, what consoles have you owned in the past? Which are still with you and which you're still working to this day? We'll add more to the list throughout the week. Now, here's the thing, man, is that what consoles have I owned in the past? N64, Super Nintendo, PlayStation 2, PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4, and not to mention handheld consoles such as Nintendo 3DS, Nintendo 2, not 2DS, but the Nintendo DS, Nintendo DSi, Nintendo Advance, Game Boy Advance SP, I should say, Game Boy Color, and the original Game Boy itself. Now, here's the thing, I can't say that all of them are still working, because especially the handheld consoles, I mean, here's the thing, is that back when I was, you know, younger Mega Crasher, I actually had a tendency to actually break my Nintendo DS's, because whenever I would end up losing in the battle tower, when I was like 60, 70, 80 wins into the, you know, the battle tower battling streak, and whenever I'd lose, I would get so pissed off, like if hacks would happen, I'd get so pissed off, like, I remember one time, okay, I went through three Nintendo DS's, okay? I went through three Nintendo DS's. The first one, I actually ended up ripping in half after I ended up losing out on being hacked to death. Second one, I threw at that fucking closet door right there and it broke. And the third one, I actually ended up going Bouffant mode and head smashing it. Or I should say head charging it. But, like, and that the thing ended up breaking, so suffice to say, some of those consoles that that are no longer with me is because of my own doing, but here's the thing is, back then I had a short fuse, not as, like, and see, today's I have a bit of a longer fuse, but holy shit, man, like, I just gotta say, looking back at those memories, man, woo! It was absolutely hilarious. Like, I wish I had the ability to record myself freaking out like that. It would have made some hits on YouTube, and it would have got people laughing, you know what I mean? But with that being said, though, hopefully you got a laugh out of this response right here. With that said, it's now time to move on to the next cool cat. So, coming up next, we have Sky Knight, a man, and this cool cat asks, if you could live in the Pokemon universe, which region would you live in? To be honest with you, man, like, if I was to choose a region, it would be the Alola region because of how beautiful and how sunny it is. Not to mention, it would be the same region where I'd be with my Boom Boom trees and I'd be able to catch a Wimpod, evolve it into a Galissapod, and I would also be able to, like, I would just be able to run wild in that region, okay? Like, I would be the jack of all trades kind of Pokemon. Like, I'd be able to swim, I'd be able to fly, I'd be able to dive. And it would just be absolutely amazing. And that right there would be where, like, I would be able to go and knee choke whoever I'd want to knee choke and be the leader of Team Skull. Because here's the thing is that, like, if we recall back in this, in the old Sun and Moon games, Guzma is no longer a part of Team Skull. Like, he just disbanded the group. It's like, well, see, that's where I'd come in and I'd reform the group bigger, better, stronger than ever. You know what I mean? And if you could spend a whole day with one wrestler, past or present, who would it be? It would be with The Undertaker. Because The Undertaker is the greatest of all time, bar fucking none. Like, the guy has personified WrestleMania. The guy is WrestleMania, okay? Like, he has competed in more WrestleMania matches than anybody else in the history of the WWE. And he has made WrestleMania the main attraction, okay? He is one of the main attractions to WrestleMania, and he makes WrestleMania a must-watch event. It's a must-watch event, and it is a very, very, very good time. Because the thing is that, like, wherever The Undertaker's at WrestleMania, there are butts in seats, and they are watching, man. So, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and let's move on to the next cool cat. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so up next we have Adorable Pikachu, and this cool cat says, I watch what Sky, Knight, and Man links me from your videos, well, most of the time, and a stranger included me, but not him, on Twitter at mentions. Anyways, well, see, here's the thing, man, is that, like, at that point in time, I was adding as many people as I could that normally I don't see their comments too often, or see them watch the videos too often. But see, I know that Sky Knight and Man usually watch my videos, so I kind of felt like I didn't need to at him, but hindsight being 2020, I should have. So, Sky, if you're watching this, please don't need choke me, man. I'm sorry. But with that being said, let's see what the questions are, okay? So, number one, are you living in an apartment or a house? I'm living in a house, and I'm still living with Mama Mega Crasher. And do I usually drive her up the wall? Yes, I usually do, but see, here's the thing is that, like, she gets a kick out of the fact I'm driving her up the wall, you know what I mean? So, number two, what made you start the channel and centered on Pokemon? Well, see, how it's centered on Pokemon is because Pokemon is a huge part of my life, you know what I mean? So, the fact is that, like, being able to share my passions and share my creativity and my ideas when it comes to Pokemon content really means the world to me. And what made me start the channel was because I was inspired by a various amount of Pokemon YouTubers. Shitty Penguin, The King Nappy, Shofu, Flaming Spade, the list goes on, you know what I mean? So, you know, the thing is that if I was able to be inspired by them, then I was thinking, it's like, okay, would I be able to have the ability to inspire other people? And I've had people tell me that they've been inspired by me, and I'm just like, bro, that right there is absolutely amazing. Like, that, though, it's those compliments right there that make YouTubing so damn worth it. Number three, how long does it take to make a video, recording, editing, etc.? Well, see, here's the thing, is that, like, it depends on the length of the video. If it's a short little video, not really that long, maybe about 30 minutes or, you know, an hour or something like that. But if it was something like Pokemon Showdown, like, if I was recording for at least 30 minutes, 45 minutes, it would take a couple of hours, you know what I mean? I use Camtasia Studios, I mean, it does a pretty good job, but then we get to the rendering process. Holy shit. That is probably the longest part of being able to edit the video, is the fucking rendering process. Like, it is so ridiculously slow, you know what I mean? But then again, that's because my internet is slow, my laptop isn't exactly, you know, top of the line fast, but it's not slow either, you know what I mean? So, number four, why no Slack or Discord? I have Slack. God, seriously, fuck. It's like I keep forgetting to make a Discord. Fuck. Like, I'm just, oh, man. I'm not a Discord guy, but the thing is, I'm sorry. I really gotta get my shit together on that, because from what I heard about Discord, Discord is actually pretty damn cool. And Discord is another way that allows for us as a community to communicate with each other. You know what I mean? Number five, top five favorite Pokemon. No! I can't say I have top five favorites. Like, I could make a list of top five favorite Pokemon from each generation, but being able to rattle off five of my absolute favorites out of over 800 of them? Come on, man. Like, I'll give you a few of my favorites, okay? Galissapod from Gen 7, Zygarde from Gen 6, Hydreigon from Gen 5, Giratina from Gen 4, Metagross from Gen 3, Umbreon from Gen 2, and Gyarados from Gen 1, okay? But the thing is, that is 7 right there, but, like, I have so many more favorites where that come from, you know what I mean? So, hopefully, that right there is good enough of an answer for that question. I'm Happy Sylveon on Twitter. I know, yo, Happy Sylveon, man. Thank you very much for asking me these questions, but now let's go ahead and let's move on. So up next, we have Cranberry. How you doing, baby? Number one, what is your favorite non-Pokemon game? It is a cross between Mario and WWE, baby. Woo! Number two, if you could be a gym leader in a game, which type would you use and which Pokemon? Let's assume you can have 3 Pokemon. I would be the all-out Steel-type master, baby. I would have Ferroform. I would have Aegislash. I would have Metagross as my Mega Metagross, man, because you know the deal. That thing is absolutely such a powerhouse, man. There would be no way I wouldn't use Mega Metagross. That's basically what I'm saying, man, is that Mega Metagross is all. Mega Metagross is the best Mega, and the fact that Smogon banned that shit, it just further proves my point. But this ain't about Smogon. See, this is about the community, man. And as far as I'm concerned, as far as the community goes, Mega Metagross is not banned. So, with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. All right, baby. So next up, we have Tickle Me Chat. And Tickle Me says, I'll try not to ask too many questions here. Number one, who or what inspired you to create content on YouTube? And why did you choose Pokemon? As I answered earlier, man, Pokemon is a big part of my life. And who inspired me? Why? I already told you, the likes of Shiny Penguin, the likes of Shofu, the likes of Flaming Spade, King Nappy, the list goes on, baby. Number two, are you much of a competitive battler? If so, do you prefer Smogon or VGC? See, the thing is with me is I'm more of a casual competitive, okay? Like, I am someone that's more of an entertainer, okay? I may not have as much knowledge when it comes to the fundamentals of competitive battling, such as team building. I absolutely suck ass at team building. That's why I mostly choose random Smogon battles, because there's no teamwork involved. There's no team building involved. You just gotta worry about the Pokemon that is laid out in front of you and figure out how to use them on the spot. So, if someone would be able to help me out with team building for 7th gen, that would be absolutely fantastic. You know what I mean? It could be, if we could even make a video out of it, it could be titled Mega Crasher's Attempt at Becoming a Pro Gen 7 Team Builder or something like that. And in brackets, maybe Goes Wrong or Gone Sexual or something like that. I don't even know. That would be completely insane. You know what I mean? So number three, would you consider doing an LP? Randomized Nuzlocke can be fun and stressful. See, the thing is, man, is that I would love to do an LP, but the thing is that, like, I don't think my laptop is strong enough to be able to pull off recording me while doing an emulator, because an emulator, depending on what game you're playing, it takes up a lot of RAM, and it just makes your computer very fucking slow, okay? And the last thing I want to see is for the videos I'm presenting to be laggy as shit, you know what I mean? And you guys wouldn't appreciate that too much, and I would be knee-choked by you guys. And the thing is, I can't have you guys being disappointed and knee-choking in me, because that wouldn't be cool. So here's the thing, is that, like, I would need to get a stronger laptop, hell, maybe even a computer, man, so that way I'd be able to pull off some of the more expert and pro shit, you know what I mean? So, number four, if you could co-op with any other Pokemon YouTuber, who would you pick and why? I would pick the King Nappy. You know why? Because I've actually had people in the past compare me to King Nappy. Like, because I was told that King Nappy is energetic like I am. So can you imagine the two most energetic forces in the YouTube community colliding together? I don't think the YouTube Pokemon community would be able to handle that, man, because it'd be a nuclear explosion of epic proportions. So, with all that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and let's move on. So, coming up next, we have Screen Pigeon Baby. And this cool cat asked, last Q&A I found out you like Godzilla movies. Have you seen Shin Godzilla since then? God damn it, no, I didn't get the chance to yet. Ah, fuck. You see how forgetful I can be, man? Like, okay. I'm gonna see a Shin Godzilla fucking movie once this is over, because I really, really want to find out just how good it is, man. Because I love the Godzilla franchise. Metroid. Have you played any Metroid games? Are you considering getting Metroid Samus Returns for the 3DS? I've never played any of the Metroid games, but they do look fun, so yes, I might consider it. Number three, Shedinja thoughts. Dude, Shedinja may be, like, one of the single best or one of the single worst Pokemon there is. The thing is it's about how you use it. And here is the thing else, ladies and gentlemen, is that, like, you've seen in one of my most recent videos just how good Shedinja can be. And the thing is this, I love Shedinja, okay? It sucks, it only has 1 HP, but it's backed up with a wonderful ability called Wonder Guard, you know what I mean? So, only super effective moves can hit it, and that means it's always going to be a 2-hit KO Pokemon, because it always has Focus Sash, you know what I mean? Pigeon Thoughts, what do you mean by Pigeon Thoughts? What do I think of pigeons? I think they're fucking fantastic, man. I mean, we got the Bird Jesus Pidgeot, have a Mega Evolution, so Mega Pigeons for the win, you know what I mean? And have a good one, Fred, congrats on 5K once again. Thank you, buddy, woo! Congrats on 5K, man. That is fucking fantastic, you know what I mean? So, with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. So, up next, we got Lauren Baltazar, and let's see what you ask me, man. Besides Pokemon WWE, what other shows or video games do you play? I love playing Mario games, and I love watching TV shows like Dexter. I love watching TV shows like anime, like, you know, Inuyasha. But see, the thing is, man, is that, like, all my shit that I watch is online, you know? And I also love watching documentaries about animals, about dinosaurs, things like that. I love watching Jurassic Park movies and video games and all that stuff. It's absolutely fantastic, man. Also, what did you think about SummerSlam? Dude, see, the thing is that SummerSlam was kind of mediocre until we got to the main event. That being Samoa Joe, Roman Reigns, Brock, I'm not finished with you, Strowman, and Brock Lesnar for the WWE Universal Championship in a fatal four-way match. Dude, that match was absolute fire, baby. It was amazing. Like, that was what definitely made up for what I felt was kind of mediocre at best kind of SummerSlam. Because, I mean, here's the thing is that we talk about the Shinsuke and the Jinder WWE Championship match. Shinsuke Nakamura versus Jinder Mahal. Like, I was expecting that match to be, like, better. It wasn't absolutely terrible, but The finish was bad. I'm not even gonna lie, the finish was fucking terrible. I was hoping for Shinsuke to win and be the WWE champion, but we're gonna have to wait until we find out answers later on, man. I really want Shinsuke to be the champion, you know what I mean? So, with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. So, coming up next, we have Colton Plays. Number one, what is your favorite legendary Pokemon? Well, one of my favorite legendary Pokemon would happen to be Giratina, man. Like, Giratina looks, it reminds me of the Saint in a Pokemon. Not to mention, Giratina is one of my favorite Pokemon to battle with because the thing is so tanky, man. And it is just absolutely amazing, you know what I mean? So, the next question is, what Pokemon would you love to see appear in the Sun and Moon anime? Galissapod! Like, what the fuck? Like, we're already on episode 40. Where is my man Galissapod? Like, why hasn't that thing been shown yet? Like, dude, it needs to be shown, like, right the fuck now. You know what I mean? Number three, what is your favorite Pokemon's type? It would be the Steel type, baby, because Steel type have so many damn resistances. It's not even funny. It is one of the most brokenest typings there is defensively, man. And what character would you like to see reappear in the anime? That is a damn good question. But I would have to say I would love to see Mei appear again in the anime. Like, she had so much character development in the Gen 3 anime that, you know, she became one of my favorite characters. She was slightly annoying at first, but then she became one of my absolute favorite characters. You know what I mean? And which female is your favorite so far in the anime so far and why? It would be none other than cute little Lana, man, because the thing is that Lana has had a lot of character development, and she is someone that, she reminds me of someone that you do not want to fuck with, okay? She is a troll, but once she gets serious, it's like, damn, like, that girl is scary. I mean, look at the fact that she took down a fucking Wishiwashi when she was battling for the Z Crystal of Water, man. Not to mention, she's just so adorable. She reminds me of a blueberry, man. It's like, you know what I mean? Like, Lana is, without a doubt, one of my favorites. Tied with Lily as being my two favorite characters in the Pokemon Sun and Moon anime. So, with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. So, coming up next, Flash Greninja asks, what is your favorite Mega Evolution Pokemon? Mega Metagross! Without a question, baby! I love Mega Metagross. It is just, it is so awesome and so powerful, so strong, so fast. Not to mention, its shiny form looks fucking badass, man. It looks incredible. So, with that being said, let's move on. So, the next person is Just Danny, and this cool cat asks, are you a Dragon Ball fan? I love Dragon Ball Z, man. I mean, Goku is just absolutely incredible. And my voice just broke. I think I'm losing my fucking voice again, man. Ugh, my vocal cords can never get a break. But then again, that's because I'm making videos every day and I absolutely love it. So I'll just have to stock up on some lozenges after this one, you know what I mean? But yes, I am a Dragon Ball fan because, like, Dragon Ball is intense, it is action, it is just so amazing. So it's been a while since I have seen the Dragon Ball series, but I gotta get back into watching that shit, man. I mean, I watched Dragon Ball Z growing up, so I gotta get back into watching it, you know what I mean? So, with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. Holy neat chokes on a fucking tree, man. Holy shit, look at the wall of text up in this. We have a lot to answer here, folks. So, hopefully my voice can hold up for this. Okay, so Aaron Midjay's, or I think I butchered the pronunciation of your name. I apologize. I'm just going to call you Aaron. This cool cat says, so, like, since I have not read the other comments, I don't know if any of the questions have been already been asked. So, here goes. Number one, out of all the five Pokemon series, which is your favorite and why? Oh, and I did include Sun and Moon because it hasn't finished yet. If I was to answer correctly, I would have to say the original series because I grew up watching that series and it's become my favorite as a sentimental sort of series, you know what I mean? So, number two, which is your favorite female protagonist of the anime? And also, which is your favorite female character in the series? It could be any other girls like Jessie, Cynthia, etc. Oh my god, dude. Oh shit. I don't have to say so far, you know, I love Misty, I love May, I love Dawn. You know, I also love Lana and cute little Lily, aka the Nihi Lego jellyfish looking girl lookalike. You know, like, I can't say I have just one single favorite. I also like Jessie too because, you know, even though she may come across as really mean, she has a big heart, but she doesn't want anyone to see it, you know what I mean? So, number three is, out of all of Ash's Pokemon, which is your favorite? God damn it! Come on, man! Okay, if I was to choose one of his favorites, like, if I was to choose one of my favorites from his bunch, I would have to say Charizard, because Charizard was, like, one of my favorite Pokemon growing up. So, yeah. With that said, let's move on. Favorite Pokemon movie, I would have to say the Spell of the Unknown, the third Pokemon movie with the Entei in it. Those battles were incredible, man, especially the battle between Ash's Charizard and Entei himself, man. So, woo! With that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on to the next questions. So the next question is, would you prefer Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon to be a sequel like Black and White 2? Or would you prefer it to be an alternate story like Crystal, Emerald, Platinum, Omega, Ruby, Alpha, Sapphire? I would prefer for it to be an alternate story. Well, see, that's the thing, man, is that, like, having it be an alternate story, that would be absolutely incredible. Because here's the thing, man, is that, like, we are not, you know, following on from the events of the previous generation. It is an alternate story from a different perspective, and that means that there's gonna be new content, new sort of action, all that good stuff. So I would love it if it was an alternate story, you know what I mean? So, number six is, so we all know you love Pokemon, but is there anything else you love a lot besides Pokemon, like maybe any other anime or something like that? I love WWE, I love Mario, I love Dexter, I love, let's see what else I love, you know, like, I also love watching Inuyasha, man. I mean, I grew up watching that anime, and it was pretty damn fun to watch, you know what I mean? Pretty gory, I'm not even gonna lie, it was pretty fucking gory, but nonetheless, a really good anime in my opinion. Number seven, have you ever watched Digimon? Yes, I have. I loved Digimon. I loved the first season. The second season was pretty damn good. Third season was okay, but once fourth season came along, I was just like, nope, that's like, I just stopped following it after that, you know what I mean? So, yes, it's like the first, second, and third seasons I absolutely enjoyed. So, the next question is, out of all the Pokemon movies, which is the one that disappointed you the most? Mine was the Hoopa movie. I can honestly say, like, I don't, like, okay. I loved all of the Pokemon movies, but I would have to say that graphics-wise, I would have to say that the Destiny Deoxys movie was probably my least favorite, you know? Like, it didn't sit well with me, you know what I mean? Like, I just didn't like the movie as much as I had hoped. I didn't hate the movie, I still liked it, but not as much as I liked all the other movies, you know what I mean? So, With that said, let's move on to the last question, which is a wall of fucking text. Holy cow. All right, so number 9 is, what are your thoughts about the other series of Pokemon besides the main slash Ashes anime? Like, what did you think about Origins, Generations, and Chronicles? In my opinion, Chronicles was quite unique because we saw episodes that we never would have seen in the anime, like the one where Misty gets asked on a date. Origins was a very good anime. The animation was cool, and the art style was the most original because it looked like the usual anime art style you can find in any anime. But I think the series was good. Generations were kind of like lackluster because the animation was bad in some of the episodes. The episodes based on Kanto were really meh because we already saw like 85% of that in Origins. I kind of agree with you there, but the thing is, man, is if I was to choose, it would be Origins without a shadow of a doubt, because that right there was where we got to see Red's Charizard Mega Evolve into Mega Charizard X and just pummel Mewtwo. That was, holy shit. That was absolutely amazing. It was also a little bit sad too, because that was where we actually saw Cubone's mother die at the hands of Team Rocket. Like, that episode, it jerked a few strings on my heart, man. I prefer not to remember that part, but Origins, without a doubt, was absolutely amazing, and Generations was also amazing. I didn't get really to see too many of the Chronicles episodes, so I can't exactly have a full opinion about that. But Origins, without a shadow of a doubt, was absolutely amazing. So, with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so coming up next, we have Amy the Smug. Number 1, what is your favorite Pokemon type or types? I would have to say Steel, Fighting, and Water, without a shadow of a doubt. Water is such a reliable typing offensively and defensively. Fighting, it's just so pow, 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 man. It has a lot of types that is weak against that type, man. I mean, rock, steel, ice, normal, dark, 5, that's crazy. And steel, because that's a crazy amount of resistances, man. It's almost too good. So what type of workouts do you do at the gym? I do a lot of weightlifting workouts because I am more of a bulky, husky powerlifter slash bodybuilder. And the thing is, man, is that, like, yeah, I may look like I'm a little bit on the chunky monkey side, but see, that's the thing, man, is that I'm not looking to look impressive. I don't care about showing off my six-pack abs or whatever, because it's hidden with the layer of fat. I'm just worried about being strong and being a better performer, you know what I mean? So here's a cookie, number 3. Oh, thank you, man. So, number 4, if you were to be a gym leader, what would be your gym's puzzle and what would you use? I would use knee choke traps, man. So that means if you were to answer the question in a wrong way, like if you were to give me the wrong answer, you would have a pair of prosthetic legs that you would have to avoid because they would try and knee choke you, man. And you would also have me coming from the rooftops trying to knee choke you too while I'm attached to a bungee cord. So you gotta watch out, man, and you gotta make sure you answer the questions correctly, okay? So, number 5 is, would you battle me on Showdown sometime? Hell yeah, I'd battle you sometime on Showdown, man. That's the kind of shit that's knee-licious, man. Like, I love battling my fans, my friends, and subscribers here on Showdown. It's just incredible. See, the thing is, man, is that, like, because I've been frequently in Showdown more recently, you know, I've actually been having some of you guys, like, follow me around on Showdown, which is an absolute honor. I love it, you know? So, what TV shows other than Pokemon did you like and or watch even as a kid now? I absolutely loved watching Digimon. I loved watching WWE, Dexter, and just like a whole bunch of other things that I can't really put my finger on like at the moment because my brain's going all fuzzy. And the thing is, man, is that like right now I am so intense that my memory isn't exactly jogging correctly right now. But so for right now, I loved the likes of Inuyasha, I love Dexter, I love the, what else did I like? I like Digimon, I like WWE. See what I mean? My memory is failing on me. Like, god damn it. Anyways, what is your favorite Pokemon from your favorite types? Minor Ice, Solo, Ninetales, Ghost, Mimikyu, and Rotom. Woo! Holy shit. So the question is, what is your favorite Pokemon from your favorite types? You know what? I would actually make a fucking video like that because there's something crazy going around. So expect that video to take place in the very near future, like maybe tomorrow or something like that. So you will find the answers in that video too. So with that said, ladies and gentlemen, let's move on. So coming up next, we got MajesticFox85. What is your favorite Pokemon and why? Ah, oh, come on, man. It's like I don't have a favorite, a top favorite from 802 plus, man. But I can give you my favorite from 7th generation, that being Galissapod. And why is it my favorite? Well, dude, take a look at Galissapod and you will find your answers, okay? It's badass, its typing is amazing, its ability is interesting, unique, and can be used to your advantage. Like, it is just incredible, not to mention when you see it at first in the Sun and Moon games, you have a badass battle theme playing because you're battling the Team Skull boss, Guzma, man. So, I mean, as soon as I seen all that shit take place, I'm like, dude, Galissapod is my favorite 7th Gen Pokemon without a doubt, man. And it still is to this day and always will be, you know what I mean? So with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so coming up next, we got Zoomy Zoomy says, haven't been here in a while. Hello, Mega Crasher. Hello to you too there, Zoomy baby. And also, congrats. Now, so we don't exactly have any questions, but we do have someone that's just like, yo, man, congrats. I haven't been here in a while, man. I'm so glad to see you around in our community again because I'm happy to see everybody in our community, man, because you guys are so awesome. So, with that said, let's go ahead and let's move on. So, coming up next, we have Fene Dan, and woo, we got 5 questions. Number 1, why you want to do video? Because here's the thing, man, is I love making videos, and if you're asking why I would do a video reaction of our Q&A's, because here's the thing, is I want you guys to hear me answer your guys' questions and react to them as well, man, which is exactly what I'm doing. Holy cow. And number 2, you're gonna do Let's Plays of Pokemon Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon. Ah, come on, man. I don't have a Nintendo 3DS capture card. I would really love to do an LP of that shit, man. It would be incredible. Like, watching you guys, having you guys watch me play the fucking game in my Mega Crasher mode, such as, like, what you're seeing right now, man. That would be absolutely incredible. Like, a whole bunch of crazy moments would take place without a doubt, man. So, number 3, can you do more fan mail of Pokemon Tony and Peluche Tommy Pokemon? Well, see, here's the thing, man, is that I only do fan mail videos whenever someone sends me something. And the thing is that, like, if I was to buy, like, Pokemon plushies myself, it'd be pretty damn expensive. I'm already broke as it is, man. But I will definitely see what I can do for you. You know what I mean? So, what is your favorite Pokemon all series and movie all time? Oh, man. Well, if I was to choose a favorite Pokemon movie, I would have to say, like I said, Spell of the Unknown. Because that movie was incredible. Animation and battle-wise, too. And my favorite Pokemon series would have to be the original Pokemon series because I grew up with it. You know what I mean? So my last question is, do you have a girlfriend? No, I do not have a girlfriend. I'm single and yeah, I can't really add too much more on that. You know what I mean? I'm single and that's okay. Like I am fine with it because the way I see it, as long as you are happy, whether you're single or in a relationship, that's what matters the most. You know what I mean? So, with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on to the next cool cat. So, coming up next, we got Zippy Fig. I can't really think of anything of any inspired questions, so I'll just go with this since I'm very hyped around at this moment. Have you ever played Splatoon, or would you be... I can't even fucking talk. God damn it. Let me try this again, okay? Have you ever played Splatoon, or would it be a consideration if you were to get a Switch? I don't know if you have any opinions on it. The thing is, man, I have never played Splatoon, but if I was to get a Nintendo Switch, I would definitely consider it, man, because it definitely looks like a very fun game, you know? Lots of colors, indeed, and it would be a trippy experience, you know? So, with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. So, coming up next, we have Phantom Blaze. That's cool, cat ass. Assuming you have a 3DS, have you ever considered joining the UCL? It's a league of Poketubers, and you draft and battle with Pokemon from every single tier. It would be awesome to see you go against somebody like A-Drive. Oh, shit, man. If me and A-Drive were to just fucking pummel it down and throw it down, man, it would be absolutely amazing. I would not hold back, you know what I mean? Like, A-Drive is a cool cat, you know what I mean? But it's like, listen, man, A-Drive, if you were to come across somebody like me, the crazy, big, bad Canadian Mega Crasher Destroyer, just know is that there would be nowhere to hide and nowhere to run, man, because you know when you face off against Mega Crasher, you better pull out all the stops to survive. So, have I ever considered joining the UCL? Hell yeah, I've considered joining the UCL, but the thing is, man, is that time, man. It's all about the time. I work so much. Not to mention, is that with YouTube being kind of like a second job to me, you know, I have to prioritize, right? So, whatever I have to do in my spare time, it's usually quite sparse and quite limited, but I do what I can, you know what I mean? So never say never, but yes, I have considered joining the UCL, man. It looks so much fun. So with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. So coming up next, we got our Pikachu. It says sub and shout out me, please. Dude, I already did, man. If you've seen my last shout out video, I subbed you and I shouted you out, man. I hope you enjoy that video. And that, like, that's pretty much all there is to it, you know what I mean? Like, if you want a shout-out, all you gotta do is just ask, and I will give it to you, man. No questions. Just be sure to follow the rules and respect them as well. But with that said, let's move on. So coming up next, we got Master Alaric, and this cool cat asks, what are your favorite Pokemon from each generation and why? I know I have a lot to ask, but meh at this moment. Well, dude, if I was to choose a favorite from each generation, I'd say a favorite, not the favorite. 7th gen, you got Galissapod. 6th gen, you got Zygarde. 5th gen, you got Hydreigon. 4th gen, you have the likes of the big bad Giratina. 3rd gen would be Metagross. 2nd gen, Umbreon. And 1st gen, Gyarados. Because those Pokemon are absolutely amazing, man. So yes, with that being said, let's go ahead and let's move on. So, lastly, we have myself, Light Goal, 35 legs. Well, wait a sec, that doesn't quite count. I mean, it's a question, but that doesn't count because it's not, you know, from you guys, you know what I mean? But Ash Greninja says, that's awesome, bro. Hell yeah, it's awesome, man, because the fact that we were able to achieve 5K is absolutely fantastic. So woo! With all that being said, that concludes this long as hell video. So if you guys enjoyed the video, then make sure you smash the hell of the like button. I didn't even bother setting a like goal for this video. So let's say 35 likes, and if you guys want more content like this, make sure you subscribe, support, and stay positive. And don't forget to turn on notifications, that way you guys will be the first to know when you see me upload next. And also, ladies and gentlemen, if this is your very first time ever viewing my content and you have yet to subscribe, well then what are you waiting for, man? Hit the sub button if you're nice and join our community today as we are on the road to 10K. Woo! So thank you guys all very much for watching this video. Much love to you cool cats, and I'll see you next upload.